Hello everyone, this is Reid. Welcome to a modern video here at ChannelFireball.com. Today I'm going to be playing with Grixis Death Shadow, a deck that some players would consider the best deck in modern, or at least would have made that claim a couple of months ago. Now things are a bit more balanced, but Grixis Death Shadow, definitely one of the top contenders and something that you should be prepared to face in every large modern tournament that you enter. So what I have in front of me, I started with Brandon Ayer's decklist from the top 32 of Grand Prix Oklahoma City. Since then, I've played a couple leagues and made a few changes, but the lion's share of them have just been moving the positions of cards between main deck and sideboard. A couple things that were cool about Brandon's list, two copies of Liliana of the Veil. Obviously not going to take much convincing for me to play with that card. And then the other unique thing is Brandon played with two copies of Anger of the Gods. This is a card that really shines against Dredge, Humans, Abzan, Collected Company, in addition to, you know, lots of miscellaneous decks. However, Anger of the Gods is a little bit tough on the mana for traditional Grixis Delver. So what Brandon did was he had a second Blood Crypt, that's a third red dual land, in his sideboard. Personally, I think sideboard space in Modern is too valuable to really put a land in your sideboard. I would not make that choice myself. However, what I really did like about that decision is that having a seventh fetchable land improves your chances in a lot of matchups, like particular when you play against blue-white or Jeskai control, the games just go on forever. You get to fetch every land out of your deck. Sometimes you need to cast multiple spells in the same turn, fight a counterspell battle, Snapcaster Mage. And if you don't have very many lands in your deck, it's hard to do that. And that's not even to mention when you start getting Field of Ruined, you might mill a land with a Thought Scour. Having a seventh fetchable land is pretty valuable. Also, third source of red mana, so people can't cut you off with Spreading Seas and Field of Ruin. So what I've done is I've moved the Blood Crypt to the main deck in place of a fourth copy of Scalding Tarn. Other than that, couple, experimental cards in the sideboard, Disdainful Stroke and Counter Squall. I like having access to these toolbox instants in a deck where you have Snapcaster Mage and see a lot of cards. I think in the course of a long game against controller combo, that can really come up a lot. And then my Dredge card, my Dredge hate card of choice is Nihil Spellbomb. Brandon had a mix of Nihil Spellbomb and Surgical Extraction, but I think Nihil Spellbomb just packs a little bit more of a punch. And even though this is sort of a life loss theme deck, Dredge is one of the matchups where you often do stabilize at a low life total, and Surgical Extraction can be a little bit of a liability if you wind up paying two or four life, you know, if you Snapcaster it back, things like that. So definitely not confident in those changes, but that's what I have in front of me, and let's run it through a five-match Modern League. While we're here, I should mention that Channel Fireball has an early bird special for Rivals of Ixalan. You can get boxes, crates, and more to get in the game early. Check out ChannelFireball.com for that deal. Okay, so I'm on the play for match number one here. And my hand is quite good. It's not, doesn't have a quick heavy hitter type threat in Death Shadow or one of the Delve creatures, but turn one Thoughtseize and variety of cheap interactive instants to dismantle whatever my opponent's doing. All right, so right off the bat, a close, challenging matchup in Valakut. Pretty redundant hand here. I guess I should probably take Primeval Titan. But let's think for a moment. One thing that I could do is take one of the cheap ramp spells with the plan of turn three, Snapcaster Thoughtseize the Primeval Titan. Another fair question is, will I be able to use Stubborn Denial to good effect against these Search for Tomorrows? The answer is no, unless I draw, and can get into play a Delve creature very quickly. So I think what I will do is take one of the searches and then plan on turn three Snapcaster Thoughtseize the Titan. Though that is a little bit risky because my deck does not have very many lands in it. So what are the chances that I'll find one in my next two cards? Maybe I should just take the Titan and, I don't know, hope my opponent doesn't find much action. Huh. If I take the Titan, my opponent will get the searches out of their hand in the first two turns, and then I could miss on Thoughtseize if that winds up being my turn three play. Although my opponent will have drawn three new cards as well. All right, I'm just going to take the Titan as the best card, and then we'll see how the game develops a little bit. Okay, so as expected, suspend search for tomorrow. Fatal push, definitely not the draw I wanted here. Just gonna play a land and pass. I can think about just flashing in Snapcaster Mage as a 2-1 attacker. I don't know that it's gonna wind up doing all that much more than that. And especially having the second Snapcaster Mage, it might just be the move that maximizes my chances. Okay, pretty unexciting. I guess I should attack first in case my opponent's only non-land card is Obstinate Veiloth. That's extremely specific and can't imagine it would matter, but good to think about these small details. It's a good habit in Magic. So remember, Stubborn Denial not really doing much without the Ferocious enabled. Alright, well, I got a chance here. If my opponent can't find a Valakut, a Titan, or Escape Shift, I might just win by attacking for four a few times. Also, I've got to the point where Death Shadow is a very powerful draw. So my opponent thinking about deck thinning, thinking about if fetching will change the clock. I think that's a fine decision to crack the Wooded Foothills. If my opponent finds Primeval Titan this turn, I lose. If my opponent doesn't, then I don't know, anything could happen. Valakut will get to work in a couple turns if that's what my opponent finds. Looks like nothing. So should I crack my Bloodstained Mire? I think I should leave it. Because it leaves me the option to make Death Shadow bigger if that's what I decide I want to do. So my opponent's hand is just Cinderglade and two fresh cards that have not yet been cast. I don't think there's really anything I can hit with the Inquisition if I cast it now. But I also don't know what I'm saving it for. Might just be good to get in my graveyard for Delve. Bolt me. Okay. That actually works out pretty well. Oof. All right. I guess I lose that scape shift. Yeah, I'm not going to bother stubborn denialing it, but I will make my opponent actually go through the motions. Sometimes it can be helpful to learn how many mountains your opponent has access to, in case it comes up in a super, super long game. Looks like my opponent has at least 13. Well, a lot of good lessons to take from this game. Stubborn denial being ineffective if you don't draw one of your eight creatures that turn it on. Drawing a couple too many removal spells against a non-creature deck, and just generally perhaps being a bit threat light. I mean, I think this is a game I could have pretty reasonably won if my draw had been Inquisition Tarmogoyf instead of Inquisition Snapcaster Mage. But Snapcastering the Thoughtseize was also really good, so you can look at things both ways. Well, after sideboarding, the matchup should improve as I get to bring in a couple counter spells and Collective Brutality and Liliana of the Veil. And I get to cut some of these fatal pushes that were so bad for me in game one. I'm inclined to keep the Terminate, probably, but take out most of my other removal spells. Teemer Battle Rage, sometimes good just to speed up the clock, and I'm not going to cut any disruption. Kolgan's Command is slow and not that impactful. Make my opponent discard, get a little value, but not great. And then I could see cutting one of the four Delve creatures, especially since my opponent's probably going to be bringing in relics. But I think I'll just cut one Kolgan's Command, keep my deck simple and reliable. Okay, I like this one. So I think the move here is going to be fetch for Watery Grave, cycle Street Wraith. Do it in that order because I know for sure I'm going to be spending my mana this turn, and I can benefit a little bit from the deck thinning by fetching first. Sure, now I'll pass and just Thought Scour. If I had Surgical Extractions in my deck, I could consider Thought Scouring my opponent, but the Delve far outweighs that consideration in this particular spot. Okay, Stubborn Denial, that's going to come in handy later. For now, I'm just going to start getting to work with these Collective Brutalities. Ooh, Colony Heart Expedition. It's a good card against me. Perfect draw. So now I think I just want to fetch and play a Death Shadow, and then I can have access to Counter Squall. I guess another thing I could do is pass with three mana open and have the option to Snapcaster Mage at the end of the turn. But I don't think I like that quite as much. Okay. Another beatdown creature. Very nice. Great draw because it both disrupts my opponent and pumps up my Death Shadow. Just three mountains and a Cinderglade. Alright, I can beat that. I do wish that I had a Disdainful Stroke in place of one of these counter spells to protect myself against my opponent drawing another Primeval Titan. But we look to be in pretty good shape. Okay, I can use Collective Brutality to deal with that. So my opponent actually can double trigger Valakut, so I'm getting close to dead here. This is not a great spot for me to be in. Okay, so my opponent's hand just mountain, Cinderglade, which means I don't have to be super concerned with keeping open mana for counterspells. It would just be protecting myself against the top deck. Collective Brutality, all three modes can be interesting in this position because just on the board, my opponent can go crack Tribalder for fourth mountain, crack Colony Heart for mountains number 5 and 6, shoot me for 6 life, then play a land and kill me. So getting up to 10 life does potentially buy me an additional turn. I also can clear away the blocker, and I guess looking at my opponent's hand doesn't do anything since I know it's just 3 lands. So what I'm going to do is play Collective Brutality, discard Inquisition to give the Tribalder -2/-2, and drain my opponent for 2 life. My opponent will respond by getting 3 mountains and deal 6 damage. I mean, a problem with this is that it allows my opponent to kill the Death Shadow for just one trigger. So maybe I just have to bite the bullet and attack with both my creatures before killing the Tribalder. And now, I don't know, I think I have to just hope my opponent makes a mistake somewhere. But I am dead on the board if I don't do this, so I'm going to do it. So potentially a way I could have won this game was just not casting Collective Brutality on turn 2 and passing with Counter Squall and Summer Denial mana open. It would have worked out better given my opponent's exact hand with the Colony Heart Expedition and not that many instances of sorceries, but I do think that using my mana effectively was a big concern. Make of that what you will. Yeah, also the Tribalder draw was very annoying when I had Counter Squall. Maybe Counter Squall is just not a good sideboard card for this reason. Alright, well, I can't really do anything, so I'm going to pass the turn. Maybe Maybe I should thought scour my opponent in response there. Okay, so that'll find a Primeval Titan, and that'll do it. So, pretty convincing loss in round one here, but I'll be looking to get back on the horse for the next four. Hello, welcome back for round two with Grixis Death Shadow. After a round one loss to Valakut, I am on the play here with a very nice hand. This could be one of those turn one Death Shadow hands, depending on how things... Well, I guess I would have to find a third Street Wraith, but just Street Wraith Thoughtseize looks really good to me as well. So long as I'm not up against Burn. Oh, no. Leyline of Sanctity. All right. So I guess I'm still going to start by cycling two Street Wraiths. What deck plays main deck Leyline of Sanctity? Like some kind of white or red-white prison deck. It's very unusual card choice. Maybe Ad Nauseam. But at least I know I'm not up against red-white Burn or something like that. So, starting with a Street Wraith. And another Street Wraith. Now, I think... I should play Bloodstained Mire and pass. Sure. So I guess upkeep, I'll grab a Watery Grave. I do want to continue reducing my life total. Now, Blood Crypt, untapped, and Death Shadow. Unfortunate. The only thing I could have done is Thoughtseize myself, which potentially, if I knew this matchup better, I might know that Fatal Push is a useless card, and that might have been the right play on either turn one or turn two. But in light of not exactly knowing what's going on just yet, I think I'm going to wait. Remember also that you have to reveal your hand to your opponent, which can have some value. And now at least I get to play a 5-5 since I've put enough cards in my graveyard for Gurmag Angler. Ooh, and finding Stubborn Denial makes me think that maybe the Angler will just go all the way. My opponent doesn't seem to have a particularly strong draw. I have to be a bit careful with my own life total. So let's say my opponent just taps out for like Chandra here. Am I countering that or letting it resolve? Probably letting it resolve. Okay, that's fine. If an opponent would deal damage, you prevent one of that damage. So I can just end of turn fetch. I think I'll go for basic island because surely this player could have Blood Moon. And hit it with a fatal push. Tapping out for Baneslayer Angel, I can just terminate that. Although that is a pretty scary card going into game 2 and 3. It's not easy for my deck to beat. I can bring in Liliana of the Veil as a little bit of extra game against Baneslayer, but that card's very bad against Leyline of Sanctity. Okay, so how do I approach this matchup? It's clearly not a graveyard deck. Stubborn Denial and Counter Squall are definitely fine considerations. Collective Brutality looks not great, I think. Disdainful Stroke, yes. Liliana, yes. And then what am I cutting? Let's put the maybes over here. I'm going to say yes to Disdainful Stroke. I'm going to say yes to Terminate, but probably Fatal Push. I'm going to say yes to Dismember. Fatal Push and the smaller removal I'm a little bit less excited about. The discard spells are passable, but not great because of Leyline. And then I also am kind of expecting my opponent to have Rest in Peace, so I could see cutting an Angler. So which of these cards am I not excited about? Fatal Push was able to kill that Seraph card. So let's say I'll keep two of those. Cut the Angler, cut the Battle Rage. And cut one Inquisition. Again, pretty unscientific, but the presence of a card like Leyline of Sanctity makes you sideboard in strange, unscientific ways because you want to have, you know, you want your deck to be good both when your opponent has Leyline of Sanctity and doesn't have Leyline of Sanctity, and it's hard to balance those two things because, you know, Thoughts uses excellent against the deck in general. That's why they're playing Leyline of Sanctity in the first place, but you don't want to have too many dead cards if they are fortunate enough to start with one. So my opponent has Mulliganed. I'm going to keep. And definitely, I'll be emphasizing basic lands against red-white prison. I am just going to start by cycling the two Street Wraiths this time. The reason is, if I don't find anything that changes my plan, I'm going to fetch for a basic island. But if I do find a Thoughtseize, that'll change the land that I fetch for. So here, a little bit strange because I'm going to cast Inquisition here, and I do want to emphasize basic lands, but I also probably want to cast two blue spells next turn. So what I'm going to do is go Scalding Tarn for Watery Grave in order to cast Inquisition. Then next turn I can go for either Island or Steam Vents. So, got to settle in for the long game against a very reactive hand. Use the Thought Scours and Ops to sculpt my game plan and then play a creature when I can protect it with Stubborn Denial. Okay, having drawn the island, I think I can just Delta for Steam Vents. I think I'm still at a point in the game where I'm happy to reduce my life total in case I do draw Death Shadow. Although, Now I feel a little silly because I might want to fetch for my second black mana. But all right, I'm still going to stick with the plan, get steam vents. I think that might have been a little bit of a misstep. Perhaps I should have just played island for my hand. So Thought Scour and then Opt. Liliana can go on top here. I mean, it is going to get Banishing Lighted. So maybe it goes to the bottom then. Better to find a creature which I can protect with Stubborn Denial. I don't know. I guess it's a powerful non-land card, so maybe I should just keep it in my hand for later. All right. So now. Scalding Tarn. Probably just gonna pass with end of turn Snapcaster Mage. Scalding Tarn definitely wants to get me a source of black mana, so I guess probably another Watery Grave, maybe a Blood Crypt. Going down to seven is perhaps a little bit reckless because my opponent, has lightning bolts and potentially some other burn spells, but having seen his or her hand a few turns ago, I'm not too worried about it. Definitely bottoming that. Let's see. Guess I'm gonna fetch for a tapped land and then play Opt. That's probably fine to draw. Since I am still just playing for the spot where I find a creature and then can protect it from removal spells. But I do really want to find that creature first. Sure. And I should be remembering to find a basic swamp eventually. Okay, there's Death's Shadow. So 8/8 with multiple hard counters to protect it. Excellent. So I think I pretty much have checkmate here. I am going to have to lose the basic island to my hand, but if I plus one and then play have play another Death Shadow and have Terminate and Stubborn Denial, my opponent can only have access to two cards. I guess it's not completely checkmate, but I'm going to counter the Wrath of God in my opponent's hand. Baneslayer is not going to get them out of it. Okay, so one and one. Remember that ChannelFireball.com has a 30% bonus for trading in cards for store credit. So if you want to trade in your standard deck and get into Modern, or just make a change when you're bored, check out ChannelFireball.com buy list. Hello, I'm back for round three with Grixis Death Shadow on the draw with a pretty good hand. I notice a lot of these opening hands don't really have creatures in them, which against an unknown opponent in Modern, I'm way happier keeping a hand that I know can put a clock on the game. Granted, like, this is a good hand, but I would just feel much better if I had a Gurmag Angler or something. Blackcleave Cliffs, usually Living End. Oh, very strange. I guess perhaps this is Goryeo's Vengeance Grizzlebrand deck. Well, I don't see any reason not to just turn one Thoughtseize. I guess I'm going to take the Desperate Ritual and just hope my opponent can't put together enough resources to cast through the Breach. It's a pretty bad hand. So my opponent needs to find two more mana sources and a Grizzlebrand in order to kill me, and I have Stubborn Denial ready. All right. I don't have any double black cards in my main deck, so let's start with grab a Steam Vents and Thought Scour myself. Okay, and then I'll pass with Thought Scour and Stubborn Denial available. So one tricky thing about this particular combo deck is it is possible for them to combo at instant speed. You know, the Emrakul Through the Breach decks, of course, have to cast Through the Breach on their first main phase, but I need to be prepared for my opponent to go off and put Grizzlebrand into play anytime I tap out. But can't happen yet because my opponent would need two sources of free mana plus a creature and has only had two draw steps. Okay, so now I'll probably just grab a basic Swamp and pass with Snapcaster or Kolaghan's Command available. Yeah, I guess could Snapcaster Thoughtseize. That's probably a play that I should have a little bit more on my radar, Snapcaster Thoughtseize. I think I missed it in the last round against White-Red Prison. Knight's Whisper. All right, well, I can't stop that. That's definitely a good play for my opponent to make. My opponent scryed to the bottom. If he or she had scryed to the top, I may have Thought Scoured them. Instead, I'm going to Thought Scour myself. Definitely don't want to just accidentally mill a Grizzlebrand and turn on Goryeo's Vengeance as an out. Okay, so now Kolaghan's Command can get back Death Shadow. That's pretty nice. I don't really want to be too outrageously reckless with my life total. But things are getting dangerous now, as my opponent could easily combo off this turn. with two mana sources could even combo off through my Stubborn Denial. I don't think making my opponent discard is profitable, so what I'm going to do is just two damage and return my Death Shadow. And then I'm not going to cast Opt because of fear of my opponent comboing at instant speed. I start with cycling Street Wraith. I guess I start with attacking. No, I should play Death Shadow before I attack. Okay, I start with cycling Street Wraith. Now, Inquisition. See what's going on. Oh, double Goryeo's Vengeance. All right, so my opponent still can't do anything. I'm going to take the Spirit Guide. Now, land, Death Shadow, attack for two, and then I should have lethal next turn. You know, a really good play for my opponent to have made there would be cast Through the Breach in response to my Inquisition, because I would be pretty much obligated to counter it, even though my opponent does not have a creature in hand. So in that way, you can sort of cash in a redundant card as a duress to get one of the counter spells out of my hand. Looks like my opponent didn't find anything anyway, but that is a potential way I could have lost this game if I, you know, Stubborn Denial the first Through the Breach, and then my opponent top decks a creature, then, you know, who knows. Okay, well, that's great that I won game one, because things should get a lot better for me after sideboarding with Graveyard Hate, additional counter spells, and Collective Brutality. Almost feels like hard for me to lose after sideboard. And then I think pretty much all of the removal spells are awful. I guess I could consider keeping Terminate, but I don't even think I want to do that. Lightning Bolt can be reasonable. Skolagon's Command is fairly bad. So I would say these are my good cards, and then I get to choose Lightning Bolt, Terminate, or Skolagon's Command. As my last card, I'll choose Lightning Bolt. Excellent hand. I should worry a little bit about Blood Moon after sideboarding. Bottom. Well, Swamp Nile Spellbomb seems like the absolute safest play I can make. So it plays a little bit around Blood Moon and around my opponent having the turn 2 Goryeo's Vengeance draw. Sure. Now, Island. Cycle Street Wraith. Now, I know I'm not doing the best job managing my life total, but I think I'm well enough equipped to win a long game that I would rather play around Blood Moon and wait a turn or two on the Death Shadow, especially since I have other things to do with my mana. Ooh, that's actually a good hand. So, several options here. I guess any of the options are reasonable. Like I could take through the breach, and just lean on the Nile Spellbomb, hope my opponent can't get another crack it through the breach, that being the only win condition that gets through my graveyard hate. I could take Pact of Negation and just say, okay, Stubborn Denial is gonna counter whatever card is gonna kill me. Or I could take Night's Whisper and just try to like cut my opponent's resources in total. Of those options, I think I like taking through the breach the best of them. So things to think about: Pact of Negation can be taken by Inquisition of Kozilek. And on the flip side, if I take my opponent's Pact of Negation, my opponent could then draw a Thoughtseize Inquisition and take away my Stubborn Denial and still combo. Whereas if I take the Through the Breach, I'm really forcing my opponent to find exactly another Through the Breach. That's gonna be my pick, though. Again, I think that's a really close decision between all three options, and you can let me know in the comments what you would have done. Yep. Yep. My opponent's hand is a Bloodstained Mire, a Pact of Negation, and five completely fresh cards. So here I want to fetch a Watery Grave. Start with an Opt. I think I like that one, actually. I'm gonna cast it, even though it means I can't hold up Stubborn Denial. Well, I mean, I can, but not. I can't play a creature and hold up Stubborn Denial. Okay, well, this hand makes me glad that I took Through the Breach, because my opponent has pretty much as much mana as he or she is going to need, and I have the Goryeo's Vengeance covered with Nile Spellbomb. So now my play is going to be to take the Pact of Negation, a hope to fade one draw step of my opponent not finding Through the Breach, and then I'll have Stubborn Denial as a hard counter in addition to the Nile Spellbomb. So there's no way from this position I can play around my opponent top decking Through the Breach, because land is a fourth mana source, Desperate Ritual is a fifth mana source, Simeon Spear God is a sixth mana source, and I only have one Stubborn Denial. Oh, I mean, I guess what I could do is I could take the Simeon Spear God and then pass, and that plays around my opponent finding exactly Through the Breach, but it doesn't even because of the Pact of Negation. So my play is kind of forced here. I take the Pact of Negation, I play Tasigur, and I hope to fade for one turn. All right. Definitely a good draw if my opponent finds Through the Breach or another, a second copy of Goryeo's Vengeance. I can lose here. Didn't even discard the Grizzlebrand. Chalice one. All right, well, nothing I can do about that, but that's definitely very good against me. Gotta hope Tasigur goes the distance. I cannot make any plays right now. I mean, I guess I can Nile Spellbomb to get rid of the Faithless Looting, but that doesn't seem too good. Chalice of the Void, I did not expect that. Wow. Definitely did not expect to lose this game. I could have cracked the Spellbomb in response. And then I could find either of my two mana counter spells. Certainly going to bring back Kolaghan's Command for next turn. Next game. Boy, how brutal is this chalice? Spirit guide, spirit guide. Ritual. Yep. Then my opponent will either Through the Breach or Goryeo's Vengeance, a Borborygmos, and kill me. Can't cast Faithless Looting. That's the good news, I guess. And we're on to game three. So it looks like my opponent has Chalice probably instead of Blood Moon. So these two cards are coming back in. Lightning Bolt coming out. And what else is coming out? Snapcaster, Opt, Thought Scour. Maybe take out the Snapcaster. Sure. Turn to Tasigur with Thought Scour back up. Ooh, Thoughtseize. So perfect. I can go Thoughtseize and then turn to land Thoughtscour Tasigur. So I guess I take Chalice here. Take two, Thought Scour. Delve everything. So get the clock down, turn on the stubborn denials. Swamp, Pact of Negation, Grizzlebrand, three fresh cards. Okay. Dodged a bullet there. I'm going to be pretty liberal with using Stubborn Denial. Yeah, like I think I'm just going to Stubborn Denial this because, first of all, I have Snapcaster Stubborn Denial, and second of all, my opponent's Pact of Negation to use the turn that he or she's ready to go off. Also fill my graveyard for the Gurmag Angler. All right, Pact, Nourishing Shoal, Grizzlebrand. So my opponent needs to draw, like, discard spell into Goryeo's Vengeance in order to kill me. I definitely don't want to take the Grizzlebrand. I guess I just take the Pact, and I attack for 8, and then I delve everything besides Stubborn Denial and play Gurmag Angler. And my opponent just has one shot. My opponent also needs a combination of things to happen. It has to be Faithless Looting or Cathartic Reunion into Goryeo's Vengeance. I guess also just drawing a World Spine Worm to pitch to the Nourishing Shoal will buy my opponent a full turn. But then I should be able to win by just having Snapcaster as a counterspell. Okay. So it looks like I advanced to 2-1. See you next round. Welcome back for round 4. Grixis Death Shadow. This time I'm on the play. With pretty nice hand, I'm going to keep. This one, let's see. I think I'm going to go Cycle Street Wraith and then probably Polluted Delta Go. Option to fetch for Basic Swamp, Basic Island, or Watery Grave, depending on what my opponent reveals themselves to be playing. Naturally, if it's Burn, I don't want to shock myself with a Watery Grave, but I might want access to Fatal Push. So my opponent has kept 7 as well. Cycle Street Wraith. Okay, Thoughtseize. That changes the equation a bit. So I guess I'll just go Blood Crypt untapped and Thoughtseize. Okay, Jund. Nice matchup for the Black Midrange series here on ChannelFireball.com. Well, I'm not going to take Tarmogoyf. I know that much. I guess I should probably take Liliana of the Veil. I'm not going to take Tarmogoyf. I'm not going to take Lightning Bolt. But any of the other three are pretty reasonable. Liliana, in general, is the card that Grixis Death Shadow has the hardest time dealing with. So that seems like a good pick. There's nothing I can take that's going to allow my Death Shadow to run rampant. So, yep, I'll just take Liliana and pass the turn. My opponent, again, like similar to my decision, we both have hands where everything is very likely to trade off, so it's not completely clear slash doesn't really matter that much what we take from one another. I think it would be reasonable for my opponent to take any of these three cards. Takes the Fatal Push, trying to clear the way for Tarmogoyf. That makes sense. Now, I guess I'll go Polluted Delta for Watery Grave. Lower my life total a bit. And then Opt. Pretty much putting any non-land card on top. Thought Scour is about the worst non-land card I could get because it is just functionally the same as cycling a card. So I guess that one can bottom just to save me a mana. All right, I found Thought Scour anyway, so no harm, no foul. Now I'm going to play Death Shadow. My opponent can bolt it, but two turns ago he or she didn't have a red mana, so not that big a deal. Also, Lightning Bolt and Fatal Push are pretty close to the same against my deck. Neither one can kill Gurmag Angler or Tasigur. I do want to get the Death Shadow into play because it's pretty good for me if my opponent just decides to play Tarmogoyf. It's good for me to have the Death Shadow in case I can get it big enough to attack or find a removal spell for the Tarmogoyf. Looks like it might be Bloodstained Mire, Lightning Bolt. No, Bloodstained Mire, Tarmogoyf. Okay. Well, that's great. I think my play is going to be grab Basic Island, Thought Scour myself. Very nice. Now we kill the Goyf and attack for three. Maybe I should have put the Death Shadow out of range of Lightning Bolt. But, I mean, at the point that you're doing that, Lightning Bolt to the face starts to look pretty good. It's fine. My opponent's hand, Overgrown Tomb, Lightning Bolt. And that's it. It's a 4-4 Grim Flayer. Pretty comfortably a 4-4 nonetheless. So, my play looks like it should be Kolaghan's Command back a Death Shadow and then play the Death Shadow as definitely bigger than 4-4. I mean, hypothetically, I could get it up to 8-8, but then I'm dead to double bolt, so maybe just making it a 5-5 is the right compromise. And not that it matters much, but I think the greatest value I can get here is making my opponent discard. Now what I want most is to start drawing some Snapcaster Mages. Definitely blocking. My opponent will lightning bolt and trample over. That's fine. I get a 2-for-1, even though my opponent will get to stack the top of the library. Oh, and the Death Shadow actually lives. I think my opponent was supposed to assign 3 damage to Shadow and 1 damage to me. But wow, this could be a costly misstep for my opponent. So that was 2 cards on top and an Inquisition in the graveyard, I guess. Now, what do I want to do? I can fetch for a tapped land. And then Thought Scour myself. 5 seems like the right life total to be at because I don't die to a hit from Raging Ravine. Guess I could also get Basic Swamp, but I might want to do that later. Just a Watery Grave tapped. Looks fine. Oh, I can actually Thought Scour my opponent. That is pretty nice after. They stack 2 on top, Bitter Blossom and Lightning Bolt. Jeez. Now I'm gonna do the draw step Kolaghan's Command trick. I was pretty close to having lethal there actually by if I had let's see. If I had not cracked my fetch first, then I could have drawn into Kolaghan's Command. I could have fetched Shock, and then Kolaghan's Command, 2 damage to you, return Street Wraith, put myself at 1, and it would have been 12 damage from Death Shadow plus 2 from Kolaghan's Command would be lethal. So I did wind up missing lethal there because of my decision with the fetch land. Okay, so I won that game certainly in large part because of my opponent's assigning of trample damage with Grim Flayer and the fact that Death Shadow is tricky with the rules and winds up living through combat damage when that happens. But that is not necessarily a misclick due to Magic Online. That's just something that could easily happen at a Grand Prix or a PTQ tournament because Death Shadow is such a tricky card, and if people aren't used to all of the intricacies of playing with and against it, that's something that can happen. You get a little bit of value there. So, make of that what you will. It is something that happens when you choose this deck. Okay, so after sideboarding, all 3 Lilianas seem very good. I don't really like these counter spells too much, and then Nile Spellbomb is probably my next best card. And then I tend to not like very much these discard spells, though I'm willing to keep in a small number if that's called for. Definitely hate Teemer Battle Rage in this matchup. Lightning Bolt, probably good enough. I didn't see Dark Confidant, but certainly Raging Ravine can be good against opposing Lilianas. And then Stubborn Denial's not my favorite, so basically choosing 4 cards from between Stubborn Denial and Inquisition and Thoughtseize. Actually feel like maybe Inquisition is my favorite. Maybe like 2 Inquisitions, 2 Stubborn Denials. My real advantage in this matchup is the Snapcaster Mage plus Kolaghan's Command engine. It's a fine hand. Really not in the market to mulligan against Jund since there's so much one for one trading. Sure. Okay, good draw there with Liliana. Let me grab a Watery Grave and play Nile Spellbomb. Depending on what I draw this turn, I think my plan is going to be fetch land, go with the intent to crack the Nile Spellbomb, and then fetch for something tapped. Note that I could also just crack the Spellbomb and not draw and then play Tasigur, but I don't think that's a good play. You really want to get value out of all your cards in a matchup like this. Also note that I don't think this is a matchup where you want to be rushing your Death Shadows into play. Like, your life total is going to go gradually down anyway, and Death Shadow is pretty likely to trade one for one, so you don't want to spew off a bunch of life points. Then have your Death Shadow get fatal pushed and regret being at such a low life total. There will be plenty of time to set up for that. Sure. Yep, might as well crack the Spellbomb. It's not really going to do anything too special for me. I mean, I guess I can turn off a Grim Flayer when I want. Now I will cycle Street Wraith right away. Now I'll grab a Steam Vents. I should have fetched for a source of black mana so that I could go Death Shadow Tasigur, fetch land, go. As it is, why don't I go fetch for a Blood Crypt. Thought Scour myself. Play Tasigur. Think I'll leave Snapcaster Mage in my graveyard. Oh, note that I can pump down the Tarmogoyf by delving here, so definitely want to get rid of... the unique card types, and yeah, sure, just leave the Snapcaster. Now, if my opponent can remove both of my creatures, I'm in big, big trouble. If my opponent can only remove one, I might be alright. This could get bad if my opponent is Liliana. What? I did not expect that. I definitely did not expect that. Blood Moon. Well, alright then. Guess we're just in a stalemate where I'm at a huge disadvantage. I have to draw my swamp. But I'm only going to get blindsided by that in one game. Bitter Blossom is very good against Grixis Death Shadow. Maybe I do want a few more discard spells just because of the presence of that card. Yeah, I think I'm getting to the position where I need to find Swamp next turn. Well, I don't know. I probably just lose no matter what. I don't think I can even beat the board from this position. That's pretty helpful, actually. If I find Swamp now, Ecolagon's Command can do some good. Not the best. Okay, well, Blood Moon gets me. Bitter Blossom also very good, so... I do want some cards that can combat those two things. I think it increases the value of both Thoughtseize and Stubborn Denial. Nile Spellbomb, one of the weaker cards that I have access to right now. Also, maybe can trim a Thought Scour. Something like that, perhaps. Yep, that's fine. So this will just be land go, end of turn Thought Scour. My opponent deep in the tank about the opening hand. And keeps. Sure, so I'm going to let that happen and then Thought Scour end of turn. Grab Watery Grave. Okay, just trying to hit land drops. It's pretty bad. I have this experience a lot with this deck. Just you have a one lander with several cantrips that you feel obligated to keep, but then some percent of those times you don't hit your second land on time. Well, it's tempting to keep the Stubborn Denial available to counter Blood Moon, but my opponent playing Basic Mountain there is a hint that perhaps he or she does not have a third land, and, well, no third land, no two drop. So both players with pretty ugly draws this game. I'm just going to go ahead and run out the Angler. So I do have to think about Tarmogoyf a little bit. Seems like I want to keep Opt in my graveyard. Maybe Thought Scour in my graveyard. Fair enough. I think I'm fine with that. So now I'm going to keep my fetch land uncracked for as long as possible. Gives me extra ability to play around Blood Moon. I might want to manage my life total later if I draw Death Shadow. So here I'm just going to go Blood Crypt untapped and pass with Snapcaster Mage open. And do I want Island? I guess I have to get Island rather than Swamp because I'm Thought Scouring myself. Well, I've drawn both of the Stubborn Denials that I have in my deck, and they're not looking too great. But I guess they will be great if I find a creature. And they are giving me insurance against Bitter Blossom, at least. Oh, now that's a nice one. I think I'm just going to pass with the intent to use that at the end of the turn. Can get back either Snapcaster Mage or Gurmag Angler, both looking pretty great here. Tarmogoyf as a 4/5. So end of the turn, target player discards, and I return Snapcaster Mage to my hand. I guess maybe I win the game quickly enough if I return the Angler. Maybe I just actually go 2 damage to my opponent, return the Angler. And just try to win the game over the course of a few turns. With 2 Stubborn Denials in my hand. Oh yeah, now this is perfect. Well, not so perfect, because I have to find a way to use the Dismember before I can cast Death Shadow. But we're looking pretty good. It's a good one. Now what do I do? I guess I can see my draw step. Just in case it's Nile Spellbomb. Okay. Yep. Now dismember that. Play Death Shadow. Okay. Draw. Bolt the Sphinx and play Tasigur. Now I have to worry about my opponent just playing a Tarmogoyf that's bigger than all my creatures. I mean, Tarmogoyf right now would only be a 3/4, but when I had the Gurmag Angler out, I kind of thought my opponent was going to have to use removal spells to beat me, but now the Kitchen Finks have done a good enough job buying time and whittling down my removal that if my opponent continues just playing creatures and fighting me on that axis, and I don't get to make good use of Stubborn Denials, I guess I could see losing this game, though I'm obviously still in a great position. Yep, that's scary. Fine. Now I could finish off the Tasigur, but I prefer to just leave up Stubborn Denial mana. You never know who could have a Damnation these days. Sure. That should be game. Thoughtseize at least will let me know what to do with this Kolaghan's command. I guess it's not game if my opponent uses Fatal Push on Death Shadow in response. No, yeah, because then he or she would have to fetch down to four. Yeah, this was a strange match. I mean, I liked my opponent's deck and their position in the matchup, but game one was the Death Shadow living through combat thing that changed the outcome of the game, and then game three, just my opponent couldn't find a third land for so long. But I do advance to 3-1. Hello, welcome back for the fifth and final match with Grixis Death Shadow. I'm on the play with, well, actually, this is a hand where I could get stuck a little bit. With just the cards in my opening hand, I can't cast either the Gurmag Angler or the Death Shadow, but I do have Thoughtseize two lands and some removal spells, so I'm going to keep it and just hope it develops well. Ooh, Abzan. So I get to play against Jund and Abzan in this in this video. I did claim that Abzan has the advantage over Death Shadow. Let's see how this match plays out. Well, Lingering Souls, I have a hand that's extremely vulnerable to Lingering Souls, so this could get bad. I guess I'm just going to take away Thoughtseize. And hope I can get Gurmag Angler into play somehow. Okay, well, at least this can't take my Gurmag Angler, which is the only card that I really care about in this hand. Could even wind up to my advantage, because it does get an extra card in my graveyard for Delve. Okay, so I get to play Scalding Tarn. I'm still a card away from Gurmag Angler, but this is really good. If my opponent does draw Tarmogoyf, I can terminate it. Marsh Flats go. So I don't think I want to spew off my Lightning Bolt. Just going to go ahead and fetch for a tapped. I guess Watery Grave is the most important. I definitely want two blue mana for Snapcaster Mage purposes. Okay. Take that Street Wraith. Okay, now I'm just going to tap three mana and delve everything but the Death Shadow. And please do not have Liliana. Okay, we got a game. That's pretty nice, actually. I think I'm just going to attack, and then Kolaghan's Command probably is going to kill a spirit and return the Death Shadow to my hand. I know my opponent has Abrupt Decay, so that's not super effective, but got to do something with it. I guess maybe if my opponent doesn't make a land drop, then I can force them to discard. No, I even knew about that forest. Surely my opponent has as many lands as they need. Yeah, I guess I just kill that now. I'm not going to play Death Shadow. Instead, I'm going to try to use some removal spells and then set up to Snapcaster, Lightning Bolt something later. Unfortunate. I mean, that's going to take away my Snapcaster, but I can't really get any value from it, so that's going to resolve. The only thing I know about my opponent's hand is Abrupt Decay. Presumably, the Inquisition was drawn this turn. Presumably, my opponent doesn't have a way to kill Gurmag Angler. Yep. Stubborn Denial doesn't help against Abrupt Decay, so going to pass the turn. Fine. Fine. Another Snapcaster and definitely nice draw. My hand has developed very well this game. Yep. And now I get to play out the Death Shadow. Two lethal threats, plus I can Stubborn Denial or I can flash in a Snapcaster Mage if I need to. Okay. Can't counter that with Stubborn Denial. Annoying, but fine. It's inconvenient. I was planning to Stubborn Denial the flashback on Lingering Souls. But now I have to Snapcaster, Fatal Push, the Goyf, and let the Lingering Souls resolve. Still in fine shape, though. This gets bad for me if my opponent draws like a Maelstrom Pulse or removal spell for the Angler this turn. Wow. Jeez. Suddenly I'm losing. I need to draw something helpful. My opponent's going to leave open one mana to counter a Terminate if I Snapcaster Terminate, but I think I've gone through all my Snapcaster Mages by this point. Well, I think I need to find something. I'm going to cycle the Street Wraith. Come on, just give me a Fatal Push. Death Shadow, that's definitely something. My one chance to attack with Gurmag Angler before the Scavenging Ooze becomes giant. How many creatures are left in the graveyards? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the Ooze can become a 10-10. Maybe I was supposed to leave back the Angler to double block the Ooze. So in addition to becoming a 10-10, my opponent is also going to gain 5 life. So I need an answer. Well, I guess that's kind of helpful in this exact snapshot of time. So I can even... I can Kolaghan's Command myself to make the Death Shadow big enough to survive, but would I rather just try to double block? Shields are down for me now with Stubborn Denial. Just a Shambling Vet my opponent drew. Is it worth it for me to trade the shadow? Okay, so say my opponent blocks with Ooze and Vent. No, that's not a good situation for me. I just want to keep this stalemate and be drawing to my fatal pushes, basically. Yeah, I have 3 fatal pushes left as outs to the Snapcaster, or to the Scavenging Ooze. Gonna leave the Mire uncracked for now. Now, actually, this is a bit tricky because I might want to trade with the Ooze before I cast Thought Scour. I think it's fine, probably. Don't mill a creature. I milled a Death Shadow, but I found a good card. Oh, if my opponent finds another white mana, that becomes bad for me because the 2 Shambling Vents would then be lethal. So maybe I should be trying to trade off the Scavenging. Maybe I should have tried to trade off with the Scavenging Ooze there. But then it also introduces the question of what if my opponent just chumps with the Shambling Vent and attacks me back. Oh wow. My opponent didn't go for it. It would have been really bad for me if he or she attacked with both events and the scavenging ooze. I'd have to go like chump block, block event. My opponent gains four. Another creature goes to the graveyard. Yeah, would be bad for me. I think I'm supposed to just cast that. What a crazy game this has been. First, I thought I was definitely going to win. Then I thought I was pretty likely to lose. Now we have a stalemate. This is a big draw step for my opponent. A removal spell here would be probably game over. Lingering Souls, of course, would be awesome. But if I get to untap with Stubborn Denial and a Swamp Walk creature, then suddenly I'm in pretty good position. Nope, that'll do it as well. I didn't mention that one as a good draw. Wow. So the key mistake for me in that game was the turn that my opponent went Lingering Souls, Tarmogoyf. If I had Stubborn Denialed the first copy of Lingering Souls, I think I would likely have won that game. But I didn't because I thought I could get it on the backside. Well, anyway, I'm going to sideboard basically the same way that I did against Jund last round. Liliana of the Veil a bit worse because of Lingering Souls, but I think it's still probably good enough to have. Teemer Battle Rage, definitely the first card I'm taking out. And then I was not loving Thoughtseize. Stubborn Denial even was bad against the Jund player, and potentially even worse here because I know my opponent has Abrupt Decay. So maybe I'll leave one Thoughtseize, three discard spells, one Stubborn Denial for the first game, and then reevaluate from there. Kozilek's Return can kill some Lingering Souls tokens, but I think it's still probably too bad to have in my deck. Awkward, but keepable. Potentially, I should have fetched in case I drew another fetch land. Sure. Fetch for Watery Grave. Blow the spell bomb. Would have been nice to hit mana land for that. Or to have a third land to cast that. But Fatal Push, Tastigur across my fingers, and my opponent does not have a Liliana of their own. It looks bad. Looks like a three mana spell. Please give me something helpful. Okay, that's pretty helpful. Please, no Maelstrom Pulse, no Damnation. No double removal spell. Just let one of these Death Shadows live. Discard, terminate. Oh, come on, Ruthless. I guess I could still win this game. Just take up my Liliana faster. I can't really say I agree with how my opponent played that one. I would have plus the Liliana, discarded Lingering Souls, then flashback Lingering Souls and play the Ooze. It didn't matter since I drew Fatal Push, but that way you get a buffer against my Liliana going minus two and killing the Ooze. Yep. Well, hard to imagine me winning this one. I'm effectively going to be at three. My opponent can go ultimate with Liliana. I don't think I'm getting out of this one alive. Alright, well, I am going to finish 3-2 with Grixis Death Shadow. I hope you enjoyed the video, and remember you can always subscribe to Channel Fireball's YouTube channel to get notified when more videos like this get posted. See you next time.